I grew up with so many different influences, and I just never, I always kind of took a little something from everything and just kind of always did my thing. I think the biggest thing that's helped me kind of find some sort of success is when I realize, and it's so cliche, it's cheesy, but like just being me. Maybe I'm right, maybe I'm wrong. You know, I come from the best, hardest working blue collar people, in my opinion, on the face of the earth.
Yeah, I don't know. Conroe, Texas, 8:37 in the morning. We're in my hometown. My family's lived here a long, long, long time. Over 100 years. I mean, you think my parents grew up, or went to high school here, and, you know, had me and my brother and sister and built a house on the same damn road. My earliest memories of trying to play guitar and write songs were in that house. We'll whip in here real quick. My granddad started this 50 something years ago. See, some of the trucks still have Yancey on. That's my middle name, my mom's side of family. But I spent a lot of days right here, man. We didn't have babysitters, you know. We stayed here. Very big part of my childhood right there. This is my grandma's house right here. Yeah, this is one of my most favorite places in the world to be. This is the barn, man.
When I was six, I had 245.
I spent a lot of time in my grandparents' house.
I mean, everybody knew the gate code to this place, you know?
I mean, just wide ass open. Just tearing shit up, hauling ass, riding fast everywhere.
I miss those days all the time. And I've written a lot of songs about those days. And I've written a lot of songs about my grandparents. I've written a lot of songs about this piece of property. Even still, when I'm writing, I'm right here in my mind. Yeah, I love this town. I really do. This is home.
My family and the people that I come from, like you call him or my dad or my Uncle Tom or any of my mom's brothers, 99% of the time, wait, what are you doing? Working. They work all the time, very hard.
His music has been very successful. He's still the same Parker that he always was growing up, and that to me says a lot for the young man that he is.
My grandpa, Bobby Yancey, he was him and my grandma were the definition of the American dream. Born in the Great Depression and just, you know, spent 80 something years just making it happen. I want to be that way and work that hard and, you know, work that hard for that many years and see at the end of your life how much that pays off. Happy ever
after. I always had this like vision that there was something crazy out there, some life that I could go build. That was my own.
In my mind, I had to get to Austin. 10 days after I graduated high school, I put everything in my truck and moved into an apartment with my brother in South Austin and enrolled in school. I never went. I just kind of started to realize that, you know, you are going to grow up and you are going to have to make a living one day. And if you want to do it playing music, you better start hustling right now. There is nothing else. Nothing else matters but this. At that time, that was probably 2013, the only goal at that time was to play the Saxon.
Load in through that door in the back, there's no sound check. This place is legit.
And I remember that night, David was like, hey man, can you play here tomorrow night? And I was like, you mean to play the Saxon tomorrow night? I only knew like 6 songs. I can remember playing a couple Sunday nights, not going on until midnight, you know, and then no one's in there on a Sunday night, and they're putting the chairs up while you're playing. So I put out that record to Limestone Kid in 2015. We got a van about a month later. My dad's a car dealer, and great hookup to have if you're trying to tour, trying to start a music career. Man, we would play empty bar after empty bar after empty bar across Texas and Oklahoma. I mean, 80% of those shows for those first 2 years were just... There was no, but I mean, the 12 Strings Bar and Grill in, I think, Baytown, Texas. We played to nobody, and we did that night after night after night. And so that was really where I got the mentality of, you know, maybe if we just do it long enough, somebody will pay attention enough at some point to where it'll pay off. You know, looking back now, I probably, if I had seen myself at that time, now if I was looking at myself back then, I'd be like, there's no way that kid makes it. But when I was a kid, and in my mind, I was just always like, this is gonna happen. I was willing to die on that hill, you know, of making it or not making it.
I didn't think I was a bad guy. I knew that you were good. You were golden on the inside, and you loved me the best you could. I'm the one that dropped the ball, got you high.
As long as the show, as long as those people, you know, because when you like an artist and you listen to their record, you really kind of form your own opinion of them and who they were when they wrote this record and the time they were writing these songs.
You can listen to it when you're in a mood and it's like the music gets what you're feeling at that moment.
As long as they leave the show thinking, man, he's, you know, he's the real deal. He sounds just as good live as he does on those records. Those songs hit me the same way live as they did all those times I was listening to them in the car, at home, or whatever. That's really the biggest thing for me. And so when they come to the show, I just hope that when they leave that they feel the same way that they do when they listen to them at whatever moment, you know, they're going through, whatever situation they're going through when they listen to them. I hope that that feeling is the same when they leave the show.